Superintendent of Columbia County Schools, Lex Carswell, to say a few words.
Thank you, Diana. We are here today to pay tribute to the 2019 Columbia County School District teachers who demonstrated superior capacity to inspire the love of learning in students of all backgrounds and abilities. The 14 here today are representatives of the dedicated teachers in our district. It is an honor for the 14 of you to be selected from a pool of over 700 teachers. Even more an honor to be selected by your peers, those who know you and see what you do on a daily basis. One of the 14 from this prestigious group will be named today 2019 District Columbia County Teacher of the Year. All I can say is I'm very glad I did not have to sit on the committee to pick one of you out of the 14s. You're all outstanding and just unbelievably great. And I just thank you for that. I did get a chance, and I am getting off the script here, which I was told not to. I did get the privilege of meeting with them on that first day they met at the county office. And when I walked out, I thought to myself, wow, I've got a great job. B, glad I'm not having to pick the winner of this particular group. It's just an unbelievable task, and I do appreciate those that served on the committee. One particular lady here today, though, that has been through what y'all are going through in the process. She's anticipated what the 14 are feeling. She herself was in their very same position, Ms. Tammy Jerkins. Tammy is the current Florida Teacher of the Year and has not only represented her home of Leesburg High School with distinction, but the state of Florida as well. Tammy has high expectations and believes in every student's ability to succeed. Her administration states that she embodies a never-quit attitude and spirit and refuses to give up on anyone. Her organization and classroom routines keep her students engaged from bell to bell. Yet her finest attribute is having relationships with her students which extend beyond the classroom. Her students know she will do whatever it takes to help them succeed. We are very pleased, and on behalf of the Columbia County School Board, myself, and our 1,300 employees, we are pleased to have you join us today and tell us about your experiences as the Florida Teacher of the Year. Let's give her a round of applause.
Well, I am so happy to be here today to get to meet these wonderful teachers and to get to celebrate with all of you, and also to see Robin. I just want you to know Robin is a remarkable teacher, and honestly, she has represented your county in an extremely just beautiful, professional, and intelligent way. So I just want you to know she's amazing, and I just appreciate being able to call her my colleague and my friend. I'm also excited because we will find out today who will be the 2019 Columbia Teacher of the Year. And as you also said, think about it. Your peers chose you. Your school chose you. They know you. They know you on your good days, and they know you on your bad days, and they still chose you. So you should see that as a great honor. And really, I can't imagine any other honor that could be more meaningful than to be chosen by your school. And I want to speak to you primarily. I will talk to y'all too. I will tell you this. I've told my family and friends that I'm going around the state preaching. Guess what? I really am today. I'm pretty excited about it. Got a podium. So I'm pretty excited about it. But I really do. I want to talk to you. I mean, you are obviously great teachers, and you have different gifts. Each of you brings special talents, unique style, and different instructional strengths to your classrooms. But I know there's one thing that you all have in common, and that's that you care. You care about your students, and you are willing to sacrifice time, money, effort, energy, sleep, and pretty much anything it takes to help your students. You know, I often say teaching is not a job, it's a calling. And I know these teachers feel the same way. You are destined to make a difference in the lives of your students. And what I want to share with you today are two passions that I have that I believe can make an even bigger difference for some of your students, no matter what grade level you teach, no matter what subject you teach. To illustrate my point, I'd like to share with you a story about a young man I met at Leesburg High School several years ago. He was actually not one of my students. The football coach came to me and said, "Mr. Pence, I got this kid, and he's a really good football player. He might even make it to college to play football, but he's behind in his grades, and he's having to take two math classes, geometry and algebra 2, as a senior. Now, that's pretty tough. You know, even for a math person, that's pretty tough." So I welcomed him. I said he can come to my tutoring sessions, and at that time, I had a tutoring session on Monday evenings, and that made the football coach very happy, because you know they do not want those players to miss practice. So he came after practice to my tutoring session, and we got to know this young man. His name was Anthony. And as the football season progressed and fall progressed, you know how it gets dark earlier? Well, my husband decided he was not comfortable with me going and coming in the dark. And to be honest with you, I was in a portable in the back 40 of Leesburg High School at that time. So he decided to join. And believe it or not, he really didn't enjoy math as a high school student or college student, but he remembered, and he could actually help me tutor. So it became a project for both of us on Monday nights. And as the evening would leave, the students would leave and we would head out, we did notice Anthony walking. And one time, I just couldn't help myself. I rolled the window down and said, "Anthony, do you need a ride?" And he was thrilled, because I found out later he really didn't have transportation. So we just began taking him home every Monday night. Well, one of those evenings, he shared with us that his guidance counselor had called him in that day and said not only did he need to pass all of his classes, but he was going to have to take economics online the next semester if he was going to graduate. Well, we could hear some anxiety in his voice. We started talking about it, and we found that he didn't have a computer at home, you know, or internet access. My husband and I gave each other the look, because he was in the back seat, we were in the front seat, you know, what should we do? And I hate to admit this, but my husband stepped up before I did. And he said, "Anthony, you just find out what you need to do and bring it next Monday night. And after math tutoring, we'll just stay and get on that school computer, and I'll help you with economics." Well, Anthony was just thrilled. You could just see his face light up. So that was the plan. Well, we soon found out economics is hard. It's really hard. And he needed a lot more time than just an hour or two on Monday nights. So I began picking him up after practice a couple of times a week. I would take him home. He would have dinner with our family, and then we would make sure math was up to date, because, you know, my world, that's the most important thing, math teacher. And then he would get on our computer and he would tackle economics. Well, the end of this part of the story is that Anthony did get all of his credits. He graduated on time. He did go to college on a football scholarship. He earned a bachelor's degree, went on to earn a master's degree. He is now a teacher and a football coach at a Title I public high school in Dallas, Texas. And I'm very proud of him. Now, I want to use this story to tell new teachers, ask new teachers to try or continue doing two things. First, please read, study, practice, embrace, and teach your students about growth mindset. Anthony did not have a growth mindset. He did okay in geometry with a little support, but algebra 2, woo, that was a different beast. He struggled in algebra 2. You know why? He didn't think he could do it. He literally believed that he did not have the ability to handle algebra 2. He had a fixed mindset. He just thought that if he didn't just catch on real quick, he'd say, "Oh, just forget it, Miss Church, just forget it." And I'd say, "No, we're not gonna forget it. We're gonna keep working. Because with a little bit of work, a little bit of perseverance and support, you can get this. You can do this." Really struggling with that concept. I tried to tell him that students' abilities are not fixed, but they can grow their brains. The latest research shows that the hippocampus, which is the part of the brain that processes, acquires, and uses spatial information, such as algebra 2, actually grows when you study and learn in density, weight, and in density, weight, I'm missing something, and size. So yes, our students can learn anything, and that's what Anthony needed to believe. So, one night, we were sitting at that kitchen table, he had had an amazing night on the court. So I was bragging on him and telling him what a great job he did. I said, Anthony, you helped us win the game. It was those free throw shots. He looked up at me and just grinned, and I hate to say this, but I reeled him in. I said, Anthony, how did you get so good at making those free throw shots? Oh, Miss Jerkins, we practice that every day. I said, guess what? You practice algebra 2 that much every day, you could be just as good at that. Oh, Anthony is not the one that gets upset, but he looked at me with that view, he gave me the eye. He said, Miss Jerkins, do you really think I can learn this material? This is hard, I don't get it. I said, of course you can. I said, Anthony, you work hard, you persevere, you determine in your mind you can do this, and I'm willing to give you the support. There's nothing wrong with asking for support when you need it. I said, and I'm gonna help you and support you. Of course I believe you can learn this. And not only that, I believe you can learn any subject in high school or college. Well, in preparing for this address, I called Anthony. We are still very close, which I'll tell you more about that later. I said, Anthony, you remember that night at the kitchen table? Reminded him of the conversation. He said, oh yeah, because the truth is, I saw the difference in him after that night. He told me something he never told me. He said that night was the turning point for him. He said he could envision himself playing football on the college football field, but he said, I could not see myself sitting in the college classroom. And he said, that night, I finally realized, I can work hard, and I can persevere, and I can get help from my coaches to play football or basketball. I could not do that in the classroom. And suddenly, he believed he could be a college student. And that's what we want all of our students to believe, that they can go on and they can maximize their abilities. So number one, I want you to teach growth mindset. And number two, some of our students need mentors. Anthony needed a mentor. Anthony's parents, I found out later, had both died when he was young. He had lived with his grandma, his aunt, his cousins, pretty much any place he could find in South Florida, from Mockley area, that's where he's from, before moving to Leesburg at the end of his junior year to live with a stepbrother, sister-in-law, and cousins. Anthony had never had academic support at home. He grew up speaking Creole before he went to high school, which was a whole nother battle for Anthony. He actually had not had a lot of personal support either for quite some time. His senior year, he actually lettered in football, basketball, tennis, and track. Not once did anyone from his family come to watch him compete. He actually didn't even come to his graduation. We've got kids like that that just don't have that support from home. So I do believe that we need to mentor, but we don't know how to do it the same way. You might be like the football coach. He didn't have time to tutor Anthony in Algebra 2 or mentor him, but he saw a need, and he knew someone that could help, and he got it. You might be like that guidance counselor. You see a problem in a student's future, and you give them enough time to solve it, and give them some outs and ways to fix it, whether it's a gap in knowledge or scheduling. You might be like my husband. He's not a teacher at all. We've got a lot of people in here that aren't teachers, right? But you know what? You can mentor. You don't have to tutor. You can just mentor and give that student that is at risk, like Anthony was, encouragement and good advice that they may not be given now. Or you're the teacher. And perhaps you can find that Monday evening or lunch or before school, that little bit of extra time, just to help that one student you know needs that little bit of extra boost. And let me tell you something. Mentoring is worth it. I always believed it, but now that I've had time, I've done a little research. I found out that a student that meets regularly with a mentor is 52% less likely to miss a day of school, 55% more likely to enroll in college, and all are reported to have better attitudes toward school and toward their education. So yes, I do believe that mentoring and teaching growth mindset can make a difference. And I want to share with you, as the Florida Teacher of the Year, we can be proud of Florida. We can be proud of what we're doing. Our graduation rate, I used to say it was a 13-year high, but Governor Scott just released the new graduation rates. We are now at a 14-year high, 82.3%. Pretty good. And Robbins will like this one. We rank number one in the nation in AP participation. And probably more impressive, number number 4 in the nation in AP performance. And for our elementary teachers, according to the NAEP, our fourth graders performed well above, I'll put it that way, well above the national average in both English language arts and math. So we have a lot to be proud of. We are making progress in the state. What about that 17.7% that didn't graduate? We cannot afford to lose one student, not one. We've got to ensure that all students get that equal access to a high quality education with certified, dedicated, caring teachers just like them, who will believe in your students' abilities and who will generate support from families or from community members as needed to make sure that every student reaches their highest potential. So as this new semester begins, I hope you will consider doing those two things, teaching learning mindset and mentoring. And you don't have to be the mentor, maybe you just need to find a mentor. But the bottom line is this, for anyone in the audience that is interested in mentoring, you will make a huge impact on students, but you know what? Your life will also be changed. Our life was greatly blessed by Anthony. Anthony blessed us. He taught us many things. He taught us about poverty and how hard it is to get out of poverty. But you know what else? He taught us about determination and perseverance. And he taught my family to appreciate and be grateful for the blessings that we had. As I said, his background is Haitian. He taught us to try some new foods. And I hate to tell you, I don't really like it. But I'm trying. I'm trying to learn. But Anthony became part of our family. He was 18 by the time we had developed a relationship, but we did not formally adopt him, but he is part of our family. He has a bedroom in our house, and he comes home for, you know, summer vacation. He goes with us on vacations, and he comes home for Christmas, but he always makes a point to come home for Mother's Day. So yes, we gained a son, my husband and I, and my biological children gained a brother, and I can't imagine our family without him. But we didn't plan this. You know, we didn't set out to find a student to take in. It just happened. So I'd like to encourage you to be open as educators to your future. You don't know what might happen. Seize the opportunities, not only in the classroom, but in the personal lives of your students. So in 2018, I hope you will empower your students with growth mindset and share your life by mentoring, because I know it works. It saved an at-risk student, my son, Anthony. Thank you.
I am truly honored to be here today as the Columbia County Teacher of the Year for 2018. I've had an amazing year representing this district. I've met many wonderful people, and I've seen firsthand that this state does believe in the education system and the teaching community. I've had the opportunity to visit with other educators, government leaders, and students over the past year, and I have reaffirmed that we are all in this together. Education is a vital part of our society, and it is still important to the people of the state. I've had the opportunity as Teacher of the Year to join the Florida Lead Teacher Network, where I and others have taken our knowledge of teaching and shared it with teachers around the state. We are also being trained so that we can help to reach new people and retain current educators in this great profession. 2019 nominees. I have truly enjoyed getting to know each of you, and I have to say that our county has some amazing teachers. You are each wonderful examples of great teaching. To the 2019 County Teacher of the Year, you're in for a mind-boggling year. Hold on tight and soak it all up. My message this year has been that as a teacher, we must work to better classroom climates across our county and state. It is imperative that our classrooms become more open and friendly. We should model respect that we demand from our students. Educators should respect students' perceptions of the world. We don't know what lenses these students are looking through, or what situations in their life have shaped their opinions and viewpoints. By instilling respect in our schools, we can change our school climate to include mutual admiration on the parts of students and teachers, admiration for what each party brings to the table. If we exude joy in the opportunity to share our knowledge, that student will feed off that energy and enjoy learning and contributing their insights. If the student feels comfortable in the learning environment, then the parents will feel that the school is working in the best interest of the child. When parents are involved in education, students and teachers benefit. It is important for the teachers to keep lines of communication open. Not only should we engage students in the classroom, we should engage the parent as well. Maintaining respect in the classroom while having fun and being engaged with your student is a great classroom management style. Most students will be engaged with a teacher that shows them respect. I wonder how many educators tried enjoying themselves and enjoying their students as a way of building mutual respect that leads to an environment you are looking for in the classroom. There is nothing better in this world than being a teacher. Regardless of the bumps, bruises, nicks, and scratches that your part, mind, and body might take over the years, I wanted to formally thank everyone for their support and encouragement. Being nominated Teacher of the Year for my school was an honor in its own right, but to be chosen to represent the district, filled with such amazing, talented people, is extremely humbling. There are so many people that have influenced my teaching over the last 20 years. I carry their ideas and thoughts with me each day into the classroom. None of us gets to be good at what we do without help. So I thought back to the people who had helped me along the way. Chances are, you're probably sitting next to the people who you found to be the most helpful. They are the people who help you get through your day, your colleagues, your friends. I have many of those at Fort White. Amy, my bright spot of every day, thank you for always making time for me no matter how busy you are or what you're doing. Thank you for talking me off the ledge many times. My door partner, Jack, you make class changes the most colorful part of the day. Thank you for allowing me to tag along on your hallway shenanigans. You should get a medal for hall duty. Thank you to my department. We support each other whether we are in school or out. My principal, Mr. Cooey, thank you for instilling your trust in my ability, for always supporting me and embracing my ideas. To the rest of my administration and my entire faculty and staff, thank you for all that you do to make Fort White the family that we really are. When I think to people last year, there was one group that I totally forgot to mention, and that would be my students. I have such pride in my students. If pride were an energy source, I could light up the entire city. I love knowing that the next question asked to be the key to unlocking a new idea. I love knowing that if I don't like how something's going today, I can do it again tomorrow. I love knowing that each morning before school, students are going to congregate in my room, talking about their weekend, their morning, their families and friends, or just simply sitting and studying before their day begins. Thank you for allowing me to be your teacher. Thank you for giving my life's profession purpose and for ensuring that my short time here matters. Thank you for trusting me to help guide you as you make your way in the world, for having the courage and the curiosity to walk in my classroom and say, I guess I'll see what this lady has to offer. Lastly, I'd like to thank my family. Teaching is not a 9-to-5 job, and my family knows this firsthand. Mary, Brian, Izzy, and Sarah, with you three, I was blessed beyond what I deserved. Dawn, thank you for your unconditional love and support.
The honor that I got this year never could have happened without your knowledge of education and your guidance.
Lastly, thank you, Columbia County Schools, for allowing me to represent you on this amazing journey.
It is with my great honor and privilege to introduce each of the 2019 Teacher of the Year representatives. As I call each representative up, I will share a few highlights from their letter of recommendations written by their principals. Can I please have Mr. Carswell, Mr. Hudson, come up? Congratulations to Michelle Jones, Columbia City Elementary Teacher of the Year. Those who have entered her classroom know that Ms. Jones thrives by making her work environment as comfortable as possible for each and every student. She welcomes every child with open arms, and the children excel. The result of her attention to detail are evident in her highly effective performance data that she has maintained repeatedly throughout her career. Thank you.
Congratulations to Linda Moses, Columbia High School Teacher of the Year. Over the years, she has affected thousands of lives in a positive manner. Both beginning teachers and veteran teachers lean on her for guidance and support. Ms. Moses is committed to giving every student the tools needed to be successful after high school. She has a passion for helping students achieve their goals.
Teacher of the Year. Ms. Dykes makes learning fun and creates an atmosphere where students want to come. Her students are commonly seen reading, writing, working in the garden, or doing community service around the school. She is a true team player and is always volunteering to chip in when help is needed. Congratulations, Ms. Dykes.
Congratulations to Sherry Stone, Five Points Elementary Teacher of the Year. Ms. Stone is known for her caring and Christian spirit, as well as a positive approach to her work with students, parents, and staff. She is exceptionally gifted at making students feel comfortable and always maintaining a positive atmosphere. Ms. Stone helps to build self-confidence and a relationship of understanding. Congratulations.
Congratulations to Alan Gatsby, Fort White Elementary Teacher of the Year. Mr. Gatsby is dedicated and loyal to the students, staff, and parents of the Fort White community. He has a way of putting people at ease and helps develop his students beyond the academic test. He is seen often at students' extracurricular activities. He strives to build confidence in relationships with all students and is a tremendous asset to our schools. Congratulations, Mr. Gatsby.
Congratulations to Julie Cannon, Fort White High School Teacher of the Year. Have her students ready for the workforce or college campus as they leave our school. No one needs to set a standard for Julie, as the one she sets for herself is much higher than the standards others would set. She approaches every task with a positive attitude, attention to detail, and dedication. Congratulations.
Congratulations. congratulations to Kelly Thomas, Lake City Middle School Teacher of the Year. Ms. Thomas has a work ethic that is second to none and is fantastic at any task. She always brings energy to wherever, whatever she is doing, whether it is creating engaging lessons, coaching the Science Olympiad, or leading professional learning communities. She is hardworking and determined in all aspects of her life. Congratulations.
Congratulations to Jamal Thomas. But Mr. Thomas was created to teach, inspire, and transform the lives of every student he comes into contact with. His continuous love for learning shows as he captivates his students with various dynamic procedures in the classroom. Mr. Thomas reaches every student, no matter their struggle with learning, yet profound instincts along with complete professionalism. Congratulations.
Congratulations to Lisa Lofton, Evac Elementary Teacher of the Year. Upon arriving in Ms. Lofton's classroom, you will always find students engaged in learning. Her classroom is well organized and instructional momentum at its best. She has proven herself to be energetic and has a thriving passion in the field of education. She always strives to do what's best for the kids and goes above and beyond to get the job done. Congratulations, Ms. Lofton.
Congratulations to Jane Yay, Pathway Academy's Teacher of the Year. Ms. Yay has been a lifelong educator in Columbia County. Over the past 39 years, she has worked in many capacities. She has a special gift of working with students with disabilities. She is charismatic and creative and always thinks outside the box. She has shown excellent classroom management skills and developed a rapport with students, colleagues, and parents that is characterized by mutual respect. Congratulations.
Congratulations. Is motivated by seeing her students succeed and excel. She looks at learning from the students' perspective and believes that the possibilities are endless. Just believe in a child. Congratulations, Ms. Amara.
Congratulations to Debbie Milton, Richardson Sixth Grade Academy Teacher of the Year.
She is eager to try new ideas and strategies to benefit each student. She leads her classroom with patience and grace, and her students are blessed to have her wisdom and guidance. Congratulations. Congratulations to Amy Roberts, Summers Elementary. Regardless of the age group or diversity of learning levels, she works to ensure all students experience success by challenging their abilities in order to encourage as much growth and development as possible. Congratulations, Ms. Roberts.
Congratulations to DeShaysha Murphy, with simple yet profound motherly instincts. while maintaining complete professionalism. She teaches her students to strive for excellence, to love reading, and to respect each other. Above all, she inspires all of us to give our best to our students, to wear a smile, to have faith, and to remember that the most important part of teaching is the love you share with your students.